Where was that?
I've enabled the teleporter. One brief jump and we shall arrive in Omega's control room.
How convenient. You've been here before. Of course.
It was no easy task, threading a path through all the skirmishers. But how could I ignore the existence of such a fascinating toy? You may trust that my preliminary examination was suitably thorough.
Trust? Aye. I trust your appetite for technology.
I chased down a suspect airship, and who should I find but the traitor, Sid Garland. Searching for something, Engineer? Something big? It's close, isn't it? It's like all my name days have come at once.
Of all the scouts the Empire could have sent. Take care of that brute, will you?
God damn it. Can't let Nero tinker around in there by himself. I'm sorry to leave you to it, but I dare say you'll manage without me. This clod has no idea who he's dealing with.
I am Gorsetsu, Samurai of Doma. You will rue your choice of opponent this day.
No surrender!
This will stay. Your defense is lacking.
Steel.
Your defense is nothing. No holding back. Leave this to me.
Tis my right to strike.
No retreat. No surrender.
With soul and steel.
No retreat. No surrender.
No retreat. No surrender.
It's all over now.
Thank you.
Temporal stasis disengaged. All systems operational. Garland?
All clear on this side. It's waking up.
Remarkable. Omega sensors immediately detected the presence of the cocoon, even at this distance. They must have been set to scan for sources of energy exceeding certain magnitudes.
I still don't see any means to control the machine directly. It seems to have been designed to act wholly autonomously. Once we release Omega, we can be fairly certain it will attempt to capture the Primal at Belsar's wall. Assuming its mission is successful, our only option at that point will be to re-engage its stasis system and put it back to sleep.
And should the machine happen to misbehave, we'll simply initiate an emergency shutdown. I confess, we don't yet have a complete grasp of its capabilities, but I'm certain the details will not elude us for long.
Well, I understood less than half of that. So, my question to you is, are we doing the right thing? What do I think? Right. Step aside, Sid. Is this the thing I need to press?
Yes, that's the one.
You gave too much for us to waste this chance, Papalimo. So this is for you. And me.
Yes! Fly free, my pretty! Show us what you can do!
The launch sequence has begun. Omega is loose.
Thank you.
Huh? Omega has stopped transmitting. But that shouldn't be. I didn't engage the stasis system.
And what does this signify? I have little understanding of these contrivances.
The launch went exactly to plan, but all signals emanating from Omega have ceased. This may indicate any number of things, but we will need to join the Scions out in the field if we are to ascertain which one.
Right. I've ordered the malfunctioning beast to go to sleep. That should prevent any unfortunate mishaps. I suggest we make our way back to Gridania.
Omega destroyed the cocoon. Papalimo's spell is fading. It was bound to his ether, you see. And if the connection is broken...
My friends, I cannot well express how glad I am to see you both unharmed. They say that Omega's clash with the Primal shook the very firmament.
You need not have worried. The battle took place far above the ground. We were able to observe in relative safety, though I am given to understand that there were casualties on the far side of the wall.
It was like watching a nightmare unfold before our very eyes. Ilbird's Primal manifested in the form of a colossal dragon, a being of pure violence. It burst forth from the cocoon with such terrible force.
That such a horror should spring from the eyes of Nidhogg comes as no surprise. Nor do I wonder at its form. Ilbird all but announced it in the moment prior to his death. Plainly, it was his dying wish to visit a second calamity upon the Empire.
And I am quite certain the abomination would have obliged had it not found itself outmatched by Omega. Gods! I am no stranger to the works of Alag, but even I was unprepared for the machine's furiosity. It beggared belief.
And how fares poor Ida in the midst of all this? Have you spoken with her?
She is up on the platform, lost in thought. We deemed it best not to disturb her, but mayhap she would welcome some company after all. Shall we?
The light's gone. It was all we had left of him.
Ida.
I don't blame anyone. I knew what was going to happen. I knew the spell Papalimo meant to cast would drain away his life force. I knew that it would only buy us a little time.
Ida, there is no need to explain.
But there is. I can't hide in Papalimo's little shadow anymore, and I shouldn't hide behind my sister's mask. 20 years ago, on the day the Empire marched into Alamigo, I was still just a child, not even 5 summers old. My father had been one of the leaders of the revolution. He had fought to overthrow the mad king, Theodoric. And my sister had fought alongside him. She was strong and kind, and always knew what to do. But when the Garleans came, everything changed. My father went to war against them too. And I never saw him again. After that, I remember a lot of running. My sister dragged me for miles and miles until we came to the city of Charlion. That was where she met Master Louis Soir. He introduced her to the Circuit of Knowing, and she eventually became an Archon.
She was your inspiration. Is that not why you took up her mask and her name? Or did you simply mean to continue what she had started?
You've known all along, haven't you, that I wasn't Ida?
Of course. We all recognized you at once. 'Twas Papalimo who persuaded us to maintain the charade.
It was silly to think I could fool you. I knew that even then, but I sort of decided not to know. Ida died 6 years ago, on a mission to smuggle refugees out of Alamigo. They say she was overwhelmed by Imperial soldiers when she stayed behind to save a little girl. She was so strong. There must have been a lot of them. I'm sorry for lying to you. My real name is Lys. When Papalimo brought me Ida's mask, it was meant as a keepsake, but I decided I wanted to be his new partner, to keep alive all the good that she had done. I didn't want to become Ida, exactly. At the time, though, I still didn't know who I was myself. And it almost seemed easier to play the role. Papalimo agreed to help, of course, but it was never what he wanted for me. He wanted me to walk my own path, and those were his final words to me. The Archon's mark he gave me is faded, and my last excuse along with it. So this is it. Whatever I choose to do from now on, I do as Lys. And I choose to continue my family's fight. I want Alamigo to be the country that Ida and my father always wanted it to be.
War is upon us once more.
Do you regret standing against the Empire? Would you have chosen a different road, knowing what you know now?
To claim that I never doubted the decision would be a lie. But I made my choice, and I have defended it with blade in hand ever since.
The battle continues, and our steel is needed. Come, Shadowwalker, we leave for the east, for Dobba.
Children of the land, do you hear echoes of truths that once rang clear? Two souls intertwined, one true love they did find, bringing land and heavens near. But flames that burned full bright soon fell dark, memories dimmed by shadowed hearts. In the waxing gloom did wane the lover's moon, watching as their worlds drift apart. One soul's cry.
Thank you.